Yo, what's up? I'm Zach. Welcome back to my channel of Ruby Mythology. Today I bring you guys another Ruby discussion video of Ruby Volume 9. And there's something that has been on my mind recently. And you guys can see the thumbnail and the image in this video. You see, well, Roman Toytrek and also Neo, and have these few of her own posse in the back. And there's something I wanted to thought about. Even, I'm not the only one who thinks about this. But there's one person in the middle behind Neo. You don't see the face. Because, well, it's in shadow and one of the faces covered in light. Some people are speculating that that person in the middle might be Roman Toytrek. And for some reason that could be possible. Because, I mean, the thumbnail title says I follow the same footstep, but a little bit different how Neo is in a different role, how Roman does. Because Roman doesn't trust anyone except Neo, but I feel like Neo would not trust anyone other herself now, and she started to have her own posse. But I feel like these are not the real humans. I feel like these are, well, her illusion from her power, from her semblance, ever since she arrived the Ever After, and how her semblance actually affect, well, the Ever After affect her semblance and her emotion, how she felt. And not only that, we all know that she can make tons of clones of herself and now made a Jabba Walker. Which that actually brings me up with something. In episode 5, we know that all the copies of the Jabba Walker can speak and eat. And because only one Jabba Walker could do something like that, but somehow the fake version of the Jabba Walkers could do the exact same thing. And this is where my theory comes to. I feel like Neo is going to create her own posse, have their own able to speak, because, well, if you guys read the Roman Holiday novel where Neo can speak, but she can't, because it's like a silent game, and like, oh, her Trivia, which is Neo's real name, and her imaginary friend, Neopolitan, they do like a silence game, you can't talk, or anything like that, and later on, I feel like Neo is gonna cheat that way. That, oh, it's not cheating. She's still completely silent. She's still playing the role of the game. But these posses of hers could speak. So, if you guys look at the image, you could tell there's like, what, over 9-10 group that she's having. And I feel like the one person could be her right hand is Roman. Because if you think about it, it makes sense. Because like kind of like a role reverse where like Neo is the right hand to Roman. And now is the reverse same way. And I completely understand why people want Roman to come back. But we all know that Roman is 100% dead. There's no way he can come back from that. And yeah, we will see Roman again. But it's not the same Roman that we all know. Because it's completely different and it's completely not the same. Because it was created by Neo and the memories that she had of him. Because we all know that Neo, the only person that she trusts the most out of everyone, is Roman. And ever since she made her first move to, well, trying to kill anyone is in the area or trying to get Ruby or whatever, there's something that comes to my mind on this. I feel like Neo would not try to kill Ruby, but I feel like she will capture Ruby because Ruby is disadvantaged and can't defend herself, and she's just a bystander because she can't fight without her weapon, and we all know she's weak and not good as a fighter without her weapon. And I feel like Neo will take the chance to kidnap her, but not killing her. But the reason why I could see this, because I feel like Neo would torture Ruby and do a little bit payback. You know, instead of just killing Ruby, why not kill the people that she cared the most? The people that she is closer to the most. Kind of like how Roman was the most important thing that Neo have in her life. The person that she cared in her life and that been taken away. And I feel like kidnap Ruby and torture her and basically trying to take everything that she care or love would be a breaking point to Ruby to snap. And the only scene I could think of for a reference for this, how would this go, is, well, if you guys watch TCW, aka The Clone Wars, where Maul became the leader of the Mandalore and the Mandalorians, or the Death Watch, and caught both Obi-Wan and Satine, and you know this line where Maul, like, oh, you know what, I'm just gonna play this scene, because I feel like this is how Neo's gonna do, but not in killing Yang or Weiss and Blake, and the real person might use a fake version of them, but I feel like she would use Yang, for example, because Yang is like the only person that Ruby knows and grew up with, because that is her older sister. And or maybe they should use Weiss, because Weiss is Ruby's best friend and Yang is her half older sister. Same goes for Blake as a second best friend. Or I could see the fake version of both Yang, Blake, and Weiss getting killed right in front of Ruby to break her, to feel the same pain how Neo is. Kind of like this scene here.
You think you know me? It was I who languished for years thinking of nothing but you. Nothing but this moment. And now, the perfect tool for my vengeance is in front of us. I never planned on killing you, but I will make you share my pain, Kenobi.
Yeah, that scene. It is a powerful scene, and I feel like they would do the same thing if they go that route of Neo captured Ruby and her posse killed, well, fake version of her teammates right in front of her. And I feel like the only person would torture Ruby would be Roman and Neo, basically double tag team on Ruby so she can't do nothing about it. Because I feel like that moment where she's going to have her breaking point. And I feel like Ruby is going to try to convince Neo that she did not kill Roman. It was Salem. It was one of her Grimm killed him. I saw it firsthand. But I feel like Neo is not going to buy it. And I still believe that John could reason with Neo. Because if you guys saw my discussion video while back, where I believe that John could be the one to reason with Neo about learning to let go of this pain, because Neo is basically the opposite of John if he didn't let go of vengeance against Cinder for taking Pyrrha away. And not only mention Salem, I feel like Neo's going to torture Ruby by making an illusion, one illusion of Salem, or something that along the line, because we did see in the trailer, and I think the opening, I think we only see in the trailer, but I might be wrong on that Neo's gonna do that on Ruby, but we honestly do not know in that state. All in all, we honestly don't know what is Neo up to. We all know she wants to kill Ruby, and not only that, she wants to know how the hell she could get out of it so she could kill Cinder with her newfound power. And we honestly don't know if this power actually would affect, would work in Remnant. All I know, it actually effect in the Ever After. Well, the Ever After effect is Neo's semblance. We all know that for damn sure. But we know that Neo's after both Cinder and Ruby. We all know that for damn sure. And I just hope that nothing bad happened to Neo. I mean, I don't want Neo to die, because I love Neo, and I feel like Neo's gonna get left behind and stay the Ever After. I just get the feeling that actually would happen, because Neo is basically shows that, yeah, she is now the biggest threat now, because her newfound power that she can make clones of herself and clones of the Jabberwockers and make tons of version of different people that she may know. Hell, we might get to see, the first time ever, we might get to see Neo making an illusion of her mentor, the one person who trained her in the Roman Holiday novel. We might get to see that. Who knows? So we might get to see that character from the novel for the first time, and the other characters, we may not know who these people are. Maybe just some random people who lived the Ever After, or some people that were just an illusion that was created by Neo. Hell, who knows? We might get to see Neo's parents that just under her control or whatever, which is kind of fucked up in a way, but who knows? Or we might get to see what Neo really looks like before she became Neapolitan, her version of herself. Trivia. We might get to see that as well. Who knows? But anyway, it's just that I feel like Neo is following Roman's footstep a lot more farther and a lot more different how Roman would. Because Roman doesn't trust anybody, only Neo. And Roman never built his own, you know, his own group. Just more of a lone wolf. But for Neo, she's basically doing the opposite and what would Roman would do in this situation. You know what I mean? And yeah, that's basically my discussion on this. But anyway, you guys, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Links to my other channels, my social media will be down below the description bar. You guys know the drill. Again, like, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Ruby is love, Ruby is life. Keep moving forward, and I'll see you guys later.